Dear students, we will start the lesson what we prepared earlier. It is a little some of the videos are deleted, some are still there. This is a complete coverage of this chapter. Just to go through, I hope you like it. It is briefly about the similarity of the figure. Two figures are said to be similar if they have the same shape and different in size. Okay? Axioms of similarity. As you know, the first axiom, we can use here SAS axiom, where sides are in proportion. You can see the figure AB by D is equal to AC by DF and angle A is equal to angle D. So it is by SAS axiom, both the triangles are similar. Next, A axiom. If two triangles having any two angles, corresponding angles are equal, then you can say the triangle similar, because some of the three angles of a triangle 180 degree, therefore third angle also will be equal. Therefore, by AA or AA axiom postulates, you can say triangles will be similar. Next is your SSS postulate. If all the three sides, means AB by DE, AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR is equal to AC by PR, then you can say also the triangles are similar. Accordingly, here is a question. In the figure as shown, it is given a right angle vertex, right angle at A, AD the altitude drawn from the right angle, and prove that triangle ABD is similar to triangle CAD. And if second bit, if BD is 3.6 cm, CD is 6.4 cm, find the length of AD. Okay? Solution, you can see this figure is now split into two parts. C is taken x, so therefore if D is 90, upper angle will be 90 minus x. Since angle A is given also 90, therefore if this is 90, then left side of this will be x. So this will be the D again 90 in the left side figure, therefore B will be 90 minus x. So therefore the triangle shown can be similar by AA or AA axioms. Now, since sides, the angles are equal, therefore, the sides opposite to equal angles are in proportion. Therefore, AD by CD, look at this figure, AD by CD, AD of the left side figure, 90 minus X angle taken, by 90 minus X angle opposite, this one you can say CD, so AD by CD is equal to right angle opposite, BD by, so X angle again, X angle opposite, the left side figure is BD and right side figure it is AD, so BD by AD. Or AD square is equal to BD into CD. Place the value of BD and CD and get the value AD. We have now an introduction to the basic proportionality theorem. Line segment passing through any two sides of a triangle, if parallel to the third side, then it divide proportionally to the intersecting sides. Or in other words, if DE as shown in the figure is parallel to BC, then AD by BD is equal to AE by CE. We have read earlier, therefore no need to discuss now. This is the theorem to remember. So it is explained also how to find out. First prove the triangle similar. After proving this is obtained, then with the help of, by splitting and dividing, you can find this. Next is the converse of the theorem. Converse theorem states that if AD by BD, D is the line segment drawn through any two sides of a triangle. If AD by BD is equal to AE by CE, then prove that DE parallel to BC, that is the converse of the basic theorem of basic proportionality theorem. So here is given also for extra information, if M and N are the points on PQ and PR of a triangle PQR, if MN is parallel to QR, then you can say PM by MQ is equal to PN by NR. The opposite to the converse theorem, if PM by MQ is equal to PN by NR, then you can say MN is parallel to QR. Here is a problem for you. In the given figure, AB parallel to EF parallel to CD, given that AB is equal to 7.5 cm, EG 2.5 cm, GC 5 cm and DC 9 cm, you have to calculate EF and AC. Here, EF, you look at here in the figure, that is EGF and GDC that you have to take. So EGF, GDC, proof similar. We have very many scopes are there, vertical opposite angle and interior alternate angle. Therefore, triangle can be proved easily similar. Obtain the sides proportion. So EF by DC is equal to GE by GC. Okay. Similarly, FG by GD. Okay. So like that, you can all the three sides you can find out. First two sides will take and prove this. So place the value of DC, EG and GC, that is EF by 9 is equal to 2.5 by 5. So EF is equal to, after simplifying, you can get 4.5 cm. For proving AC, you can take now again back the other part of the triangle. You can see back again the figure. The figure you can see here, CEF and ABC. Look at this, CEF and ABC. So CEF and ABC, these two parts we have taken. Then you can easily prove the similar. We have two corresponding angles and a common angle. So by AAA, triangle ABC can be similar to triangle EFC. Then you can find out sides corresponding AC by EC. AC by EC is equal to BC by CF is equal to AB by EF. So necessary parts you can take. AC by EC is equal to AB by EF. So AC by 7.5 is equal to 7.5 by 4.5 cm. Find out by simplifying, AC is equal to 12.5 cm. Okay. Next, ratios of areas of similar triangles. Here you see similar triangles with ratio of their areas and also perimeter. You can find out perimeter. Remember, it remains also same as the ratio of their corresponding sides. However, areas will be little differing. So remember, if two triangles are similar, as shown in the figure, ABC and DEF are two similar triangles, then you can take the help of the area property of triangle, half base unit height, you can prove this one. However, we are not going to discuss that one now, to remember now. So area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF, it is square ratio of the corresponding sides of the similar triangles. That means area of ABC by area of DEF is equal to AB square by D square is equal to BC square by EF square is equal to AC square by DF square. Also, if you take perpendicular also, you can tell AM square by DN square. Okay. Some problem accordingly. Here is a problem given DE parallel to BC. Prove that AD triangle is similar to ABC. Given that if AD is half of BD, then calculate DE. Okay. If BC is 4.5 cm, second bit. Also find out area of ADE by area of ABC and area of ADE by area of trapezium BCDE. For that, first you have to prove triangle ADE similar to triangle ABC. You can see DE parallel to BC given. So you can prove easily because corresponding angles are equal. And by AAA or by AA, you can say triangle ADE similar to triangle ABC. Once you prove similar, you can tell AD by, you can prove AD by AB is equal to AE by AC is equal to DE by BC. Since in the question it is given, AD is equal to half of BD. So AD is equal to half of BD or AD is equal to 1, BD is equal to 2. You can look at the right side, upper part. If you take, then AD by, if you write, if you want to find out AB, what you have to do? AB, as you know, AB, AD plus BD. So 1 plus 2, that is equal to 1 by 3. So to find out AD by AB, you have to take 1 by 1 plus 2. So therefore, 1 by 3. That is, by estimation or calculation, you can find out. So DE by BC is equal to AD by AB, you have obtained already. Place the value here, DE by BC 4.5 is equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, DE is equal to 1.5. We know that the ratio of the between the areas of two similar triangles, ratio of their square of their corresponding sides. Therefore, area of ADE by area of ABC is equal to DE square by BC square. That is equal to 1 by 9. To find out area of ADE by area of trapezium BCDE, you have to subtract the area of ADE from the triangle ABC. So that means upper one is 1, ABC is area of ADC is 1 unit, area of ABC 9 unit. Therefore, area of trapezium BCED is equal to 9 unit minus 1 unit, that is equal to 8 unit. So therefore, area of AD by area of trapezium BCED is equal to 1 by 8. Next question for you. In the given figure, D parallel to BC and the triangle ABC and AD is to DB is equal to 5:3. Find the ratio AD by AB, then DE by BC, then area of DEF by area of DEC. Okay, so AD by DB is given 5:3. Therefore, AD by AB, if you want to find AD plus DB, you have to take. So therefore, 5 unit AD, 3 unit BD. Therefore, AB is equal to 5 unit plus 3 unit, 8 unit. Therefore, AD by AB is equal to 5/8. Since triangle ADE similar to triangle ABC, we can DE parallel to BC given. So we can prove also by AA, triangle ADE similar to triangle ABC. Therefore, DE by BC is equal to AD by AB is equal to AE by AC. Therefore, if you place the value DE by BC by AD by AB is equal to 5/8. After that, we want to find out, since area of DEF and area of DEC have the common vertex, look at here, DEF and BEC, BFC, DEF and DEC, DEF and DEC, they have the common vertex, is DE, so therefore, the ratio of their bases will be DF by DC. So therefore, area of triangle DEF by area of triangle DEC is equal to DF by DC. So place the value DF by DC. So that is equal to 5/8. Okay. So find out DEF first, because DF by FC you do not know that value. First you have to go to the original figure. First you have to prove similar. DEF similar to BFC. Look at this figure. DEF BFC. From this we can develop the relation between DE by BC is equal to DF by FC is equal to EF by BF. Okay? So therefore you have to prove similar. We can easily prove this one by AA triangle DEF similar to triangle BFC, because you have entered alternate angle, vertically opposite angle. You can prove this. Then you can find out DE by BC is equal to EF by BF is equal to DF by FC. Okay, so you can place here D by FC is equal to DE by BC is equal to 5/8. Now, DF BC, you can DF by FC given, FC, you can write DF by DF plus FC, if you take that total will come DC. Therefore, DF by DC is equal to 5/13. So, area of DF by area of DEC is equal to DF ratio of their bases, that is DF by DC. Therefore, 5/13. Now, question for the part from size transformation. So, it is related to the similar triangle about the smaller and bigger figures. Some questions, general application questions, you can say. Normally, if you want to find out the size of the image, always it is k times the corresponding given figure. Area of the resulting figure will be k square times the area of given figure. And volume of the resulting figure is equal to kq times the volume of the given figure. Provided, remember, k is if k greater than 0, it is enlargement, k less than 0 is reduction, and k equal to then identity transformation. Here some question regarding that. The scale given 1:50,000 in the map, a triangular plot ABC of land has the following dimension. AB 2 cm, BC 3.5 cm, and angle ABC 90°. You have to calculate the actual area of the side BC in kilometer of the land and the area of the plot in square kilometer. Since clearly the given scale K is equal to 1/50,000, the length of the side in the map is equal to, how to find out? It's K times the actual length of the land. Therefore, if you put it here, 1/50,000 is the actual length of the map. Therefore, actual length of the land, that is BC. So the actual length of BC is equal to 50,000 and 3.5. So that will give you 50,000 into 3.5 is 1.75 kilometer. Then area of ABC in the map is equal to half into base into height. If you put 3.5 square centimeter, then area of the triangle ABC in the map is equal to k square time into actual area of the triangular plot of ABC. So that is equal to 3.5 into 1/50,000 actual area of the plot. therefore actual area is equal to 3.5 into 50,000 into 50,000. If you multiply this, you can multiply and get the result. Dear students, you have seen the video. It is a brief approach to go through the complete chapter. I hope all of you might be understanding this chapter. You have earlier discussed many things, many about sums, problems related to this. We have discussed, and this is the last part of this. Next part, we will be watching for the similarity test. Get ready for the test, prepare well. There will be questions for test after this video. So thank you for watching. If you like this video, you can give your comments.